Now, the WGAL News 8 Storm Team Forecast with meteorologist Matt Moore.
Well, certainly was a crisp start to the morning here. Earlier on, we had right around sunrise, lows were down into the 40s in many spots, even some spots bordering close to the 30s here earlier this morning. Lewistown with a low of 40 degrees, a lot of mid to upper 40s, and this might be the last time we get anywhere close to these numbers, at least for a little while here. We're not expecting to see temperatures quite like that. A little dose of some cooler, more crisp weather here that we saw this morning. But we're going to see that changing over the next, I would say, 24 hours here. Right now, we've rebounded nicely back into the upper 60s and low 70s. And a pretty splendid afternoon is expected. Just some high clouds out there, 67 in York. And that's where we go to take a live look right now. Some blue sky, some sunshine reaching the ground as well. So we do have some of these high clouds that are drifting in from northwest to southeast. And it is running along the edge of a warm front, which as we head into tomorrow, that warm front passes through and it sets the stage for some instability. And we're talking about the chance of some strong to severe thunderstorms later tomorrow afternoon, but not today. In fact, today, enjoy it because it will be a nice one. Highs low to mid 70s, just some filtered sunshine, but all around pretty comfortable from this afternoon and into this evening. Mostly cloudy tonight. That's as that warm front gets closer, and that warm front could potentially spark a shower or storm overnight tonight and into tomorrow morning. Doesn't really look that widespread until maybe later tomorrow afternoon, the potential for some scattered thunderstorms to fire up, and some of them could be strong to severe. So as of right now, we do have that impact icon in. There's been a little bit of discussion amongst the meteorologists here, Christine, Ethan, Joe, myself, maybe going with an alert day for tomorrow, potentially because of some of those strong to severe thunderstorms. So we'll talk a little bit more about that coming up in just a second. But right now, here is that storm system. It's been producing some severe weather out in the Central Plains. Of course, all that flooding, you saw that story earlier in the newscast. And some showers out here into the Ohio Valley so far today. The severe risk today is going to be out in the Central Plains, but tomorrow that severe threat shifts a little farther to the east here, especially across parts of the mid-Atlantic, and that's what we'll be watching for. And the Storm Prediction Center has most of central Pennsylvania in an enhanced risk for severe weather. Now, that's probably about a 3 out of 5 on our scale of those severe risks from the Storm Prediction Center, but it does include the vast majority of the Susquehanna Valley. And in terms of all the ingredients coming together, it is one of those days where a lot of the ingredients that we look for are going to be overlapping each other pretty much right over central Pennsylvania, and that doesn't usually happen too often every year. So of course it is something that's piquing our interest to going into tomorrow itself. But in the meantime, it will stay quiet, and predictor shows that until we get into, looks like overnight, could be a couple of showers and maybe a rumble of thunder. That's as the warm front goes through. So there's a lot more humidity and some warmth down south of this front, and that's what sets the stage tomorrow afternoon. You can see these broken lines of storms as they cruise through the afternoon and evening hours. And then once we hit around sunset and after, that severe threat will go down. But lots of storm energy for tomorrow. Here's a look at predictor showing that storm energy, and you can see it's on that moderate to high side of the scale. There is some spin in the atmosphere too, so we are expecting all types of forms of severe weather to be possible as we head into tomorrow. You can see the threats there. So of course we'll keep you up to date on that as we get closer. We're going to, Joe Calhoun and myself, will look at some information this afternoon and give you some updates later on today. Friday though looks better. We'll watch for some additional showers and storms on Saturday and maybe a couple of stray storms Sunday and into Memorial Day itself. But it looks like for the most part the holiday weekend will stay quieter than what we will see maybe tomorrow afternoon.
All right, so a little tricky one tomorrow.
It could be, yeah. So active and just stay weather aware for you.
All right, very good. Thanks, Matt.